Okay, here we go. The red button material.
Oh, hello, red button people.
Don't pander to them. I don't like it. It's intrusive.
You think it's intrusive?
Yeah, I mean, they just press a button and we appear like a butler or a lift.
Or a lion.
What?
Nothing, sorry.
No, but seriously, I think it's demeaning.
Well, we can do it back to them.
Do what back? You're going to be tiresome.
No, we can do it back to them. We can press our own red button and look at them at home.
Really? What? Like NTV?
Yeah, is it?
But shall we give it a go then? Which one's the red button?
It's the red button, David.
I hate the red button. I mean, I hate the fact of it, physically. The correct colour for buttons is black or, at a pinch, grey. In fact, at home, I don't have a red button. Do you know why? I've coloured them all in pen. Otherwise, the remote control looks like a sort of sweet shop. It's disgusting.
Press the button.
Which one?
The...
Okay. The on the left. Yeah. Call it the one on the left.
The one on the left.
I don't think we should pander to it.
Oh, look at all the people.
Oh, God. These are our people.
Oh, look at that man with dark hair doing that. Oh, stop that. Oh,
he must really like the show.
Mm. Look, that woman's doing the ironing. I think that's been insulting, actually.
Yeah. Well, you see, there's this whole multitasking myth that's been put about by Cosmo. The reality is that one of those two jobs is being done badly, and I hope to God it's the ironing.
Is that Richard Dawkins?
It is!
Hello, Richard Dawkins. I didn't know he was a fan. That's nice. Of course.
Don't worry.
We're joking.
We can't see you.
We can't really see you. That was just a skit.
Just a skit.
Yeah.
But no, we can't see you.
We can't see you.
Apart from you.
Except for you. Gentlemen, let me introduce you to Mr. Hudson, who's going to be working on the advertising for our new liner.
Great to be on board, as it were.
Well, you're not on board. We haven't finished building it yet.
No, but on board might also mean involved in the project.
I don't think it does.
Well, it might do. And if it did, and the project was to do with a ship, saying you were on board would be doubly apposite.
Surely only if your announcement of involvement were made while actually on it. I'm afraid I think you're trying to pun an idiom, the existence of which I dispute, with a state of shipboardness that is evidently lacking. Did you work hard on that opening?
You never get a second chance to make a first impression.
That is the cleverest thing I've ever heard! You've totally regained my confidence. Tell us your advertising ideas for our liner.
Well, these are my main two thoughts. What I'm trying to get across is what a brilliant boat this is going to be, and that consequently it won't in any way sink.
Don't you think we should emphasise the catering?
What?
The catering, the restaurants on board, the ballroom.
Or the band, we can mention the band.
The plumbing.
The paintwork.
The crockery.
The lifeboats.
No!
The seats.
Well, not really. From the brief I was given, I thought that the whole thing about this ship is that it's a triumph of human engineering. Yes, it's luxurious, but that goes without saying. Its selling point is its unsinkability. Hence, God himself couldn't sink her.
Right.
So what's the problem?
Well, I suppose our worry is, what if it sinks?
What if it sinks?
Yes, what if it sinks? We'll end up looking pretty daft if it sinks, saying, you know, that it wouldn't sink.
It would look like we were tempting fate, if it sinks.
Is it going to sink?
No, of course it's not going to sink.
It might sink.
Well...
anything might sink, you know. And if it does sink, this campaign is going to leave us with egg on our faces.
So, what are you thinking? Titanic, it might sink. Anything might sink. International travel, not for the faint-hearted.
No, emphasise the catering.
What if everyone gets the shit?
There's no need to be crude.
I'm sorry, but you've got to give me something to run with here. You told me that the whole thing about this ship is that it's really incredibly unlikely to sink. Massively even more unlikely to sink than ships already are. And now I'm not allowed to mention it in the marketing.
Well, I'm just worried about the irony if it sinks.
Is it going to sink?
Probably not, but this campaign will make us look stupid if it does.
Well, if it sinks, you'll look stupid anyway. You'll be the bunch of shipbuilders that built a ship with all holes in it or whatever.
No, I see.
And if it doesn't sink, but you've marketed it on the basis that it might, you'll look stupid when you go bankrupt because everyone's too scared to get on it.
How about we go with two posters, Titanic unsinkable and Titanic sinkable. And then, if it sinks, we can pretend we thought it was, like, flammable and inflammable.
That might cover us.
Why are you so convinced that this ship is going to sink?
Sod's law.
It's like arranging a picnic in July with no wet weather venue. It's bound to rain.
And similarly, this ship is bound to sink because it hasn't got anywhere near enough lifeboats.
Well, why don't you build some more?
We spent all that money on the marketing.
Unbelievable.
What?
You know.
I
just think you've got a game plan.
What?
I just think you're only here to win. I mean, I'm just being myself. This is a chance for me to show people what I'm really like. You know, the real me. But it just spoils it when... I mean, every time you move one of those pieces, it's like, is this going to help me win?
You're so fake. I can't believe you'd say that about me. I am so only here for the experience. I'm not interested in winning. We're both winners just by being here.
That is so fake.
Oh, right. You're taking that pawn, are you?
Yeah, why?
You know I really liked that pawn. I told you on, like, day one that I really liked that pawn. Can't believe I trusted you. That's my problem. I'm too trusting. I mean, people don't notice it about me because I don't actually like talking about myself, but I'm really trusting.
Look, I took the pawn, right? Deal with it. I'm not here to make friends.
All right, fine. Fine. We'll just stay out of each other's way. I'll stay on my side of the board and you stay on yours. Checkmate.
I'm not your mate.
5 minutes for lighting.
I mean, I know everyone's been going on about it for ages, but I really do think it's the best police drama ever made. I mean, you should really get all the box sets and everything, definitely.
Really?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, it's got, you know, it's got all the crises that have happened to the working class over the last decade, the police procedures, but then that sort of turns into a portrait of the city's corrupt local government, the failing schools. The acting is just amazing. It's just, it's got everything.
Okay, well, I'll give it a go. The Bill, you say?
Yeah, it's called The Bill. You do it, you won't regret it.
Great. And, hey, Rob,
Yeah?
I just want to say thanks.
Do you?
Yeah.
Okay, for what?
Well, for being brilliant about it.
I'm not quite sure I know what you're...
There you go again, being brilliant and my oldest friend about it. You know what? This.
This what?
I mean it, Robert. Thanks for being fine about me wearing women's clothes. Because it was a really tough decision to do it, to come on set as me. But you've been amazing.
Are you wearing women's clothes?
You? Yes. No, look, this blouse does up the wrong way. These are ladies' trousers, ladies' trains. This is even a lady's watch.
Are you sure they're women's clothes?
Of course I'm bloody sure. I got them all from this excellent catalogue called Comfortable Woman, which was both extremely reasonably priced and very prompt when it came to delivery.
Okay, yeah, fine, right, fine. Are you wearing a bra?
It's just a training bra.
Okay. Well, great. I mean, does this mean you're going to start flower arranging and doing baking and reading the number one ladies detective agency?
No, don't be so narrow-minded. I'm not turning into a woman. I'm just dressing like one. God, I thought you were cool with it.
I am cool with it. I'm properly cool with it. You look really, really, comfortable.
And?
And feminine. Really, really comfortable and feminine and pretty.
Thank you.
Of course, if this was a sketch, at this point James would walk by in proper drag and we'd all talk about how we fancy him or something.
Yeah. Shame. That would have been good.
Yeah.
animations that we've done some animations. We've done the voices.
We did the voices. Who's the voice?
Other people did the words.
Do not panic.
And other people did the drawings, and they're very funny.
Don't let them touch you, they'll take your eyes.
I see flames. Doggy dips. Good enough for God's dog himself.
You all right, Temperature Knob? Is he fiddling with you again?
We are definitely flightless, are we?
Is it just me, or was that a bit sh**?
And so it was all to do with various pertinent clicks you need to do after this, which I don't have information on.
But you'll figure it out.